There are four functions in DAX to retrieve the current date and time. They are today, UTCTODAY, now, and UTCNOW. Today returns today using the current time zone. So it's the 3rd of November 2020. And you see that the time part is always empty because today only returns the date part. UTCTODAY returns today again, but using the UTC standard. And it's the same day both here and in UTC. Now, on the other hand, returns both the date and the time part. So it's 9:38 a.m. considering now in the current time zone. And because I'm in the European time zone, there is one hour of difference between UTC and now. Now, an important part to remember is that UTC is not GMT. GMT is a time zone, UTC is a standard. As such, GMT obeys daylight saving times, whereas UTC never uses daylight saving time. And an important detail is from where the time zone is taken. It is taken from the server that is running the engine. So if you are using a database server, it's the time zone configured on the server. If you are using a Power BI desktop file, it's the time zone configured on your PC. The Power BI service, on the other hand, always uses UTC. So there are no differences in Power BI between now and UTC now. But there might be a difference if you evaluate now on your Power BI desktop file on your PC, and then you upload the file on the Power BI service, because the Power BI service will use UTC. If you want to understand the difference between the current time zone and UTC, you can use a simple math between dates. You can subtract from today UTC today, and the difference is the number of days between the current time zone and UTC. In our case, there are no differences. When it comes to compute the difference in hours, you can do the subtraction between now and UTC now, but you will need to multiply the result by 24 because the time part of a daytime is always a fraction of 1, the fraction that represents the part of the day in daytime. And there is 1 hour of difference between UTC and the current time zone. As an example of using date and time now and UTC now and today, we can compute the age of customers as of today. And to do that, for every customer name and birth date, I first compute today minus the customer birth date, and this represents the difference, the age of the customer expressed in days. But it also represents a date that I can use to do further math. I can extract the year from the age. And because 0 in DAX is 1900, the 1st of January 1900, I need to subtract 1900 to compute the age in years. Whereas for the month, I can just take the month of the age. And then I format these numbers as strings in order to produce the result that you see here that shows for each customer its age using years and months.